Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. Last time we wrapped up most of the regular tasks on the Black River map and started getting prepared for the timed contests. In Hard Mode, we're limited to 3 attempts per contest. The first is food delivery, which requires us to deliver 2 loads of consumables from the farm to the drilling site in under 6 minutes for the maximum reward. Pinewood Express requires us to deliver 2 loads of planks from the lumber mill to the drill site and 1 load each to the church and the old house in under 8 minutes. Meteorology data requires us to visit the 3 weather sensors as checkpoints from the starting point near the factory. Cockpit view is required for this one and we'll have 10.5 minutes to complete this. We'll start with the food delivery contest. I'll run the White Western Star to the farm after filling it up with fuel. To avoid loading fees, we'll need a truck with a crane, so I'll bring the Fleet Star down to assist. The White Western Star with the 2100T engine and off-road gearbox should be able to cruise through the off-road sections in high gear with ease. On the paved road sections, I'll switch to auto and then back into high when we hit the dirt. We completed the first delivery in 3 minutes 20 and earned enough XP to make it to rank 9. The food delivery contest is well worth doing 3 times over, so I'll head back to the farm and go again. Doing this contest back to back will churn up the ground in some sections, which will limit traction, so expect times to drop off slightly on subsequent attempts. Veering your line where possible can help to avoid this. On the way back for the last attempt at the food delivery contest, I'll pick up the sideboard trailer we left at the fuel station and drop it off at the farm for later. We've exhausted all our attempts for that contest, but we've earned a decent amount of money and XP along the way. Touch the maintenance trailer here at the drill site, which will need to eventually be delivered to Smithfield Dam for a later contract. The P16 needs a top up, so I'll bring it over and refuel it from the maintenance trailer. I almost messed up here, as recover is just before refuel on the menu, and if I'd not been paying attention, that would have been an $8,000 mistake. I'll need to move the P16 back out of the way, as we'll need to be able to turn around again in the loading zone later. Next, we'll need to start preparing for the Pinewood Express contest. Bring along both sideboard trailers with the Fleet Star so we can load them up at the lumber mill. Thank you. we'll also need to load up the White Western Star. Quickly jump into the White Western Star to make sure the cargo is packed while I think of it, as it's easy enough to forget and this can easily ruin a contest attempt. Back in the Fleet Star, I'm going to take the two trailers into the town. One I'll deliver to the town storage as part of the Steel River Supplies contract. The other I'm going to leave near the church to use as part of the Pinewood Express contest. I have to give YouTuber SarRacer or SarRacer credit for this idea. They're also doing a hard mode playthrough and I'll leave a link to their channel in the description. As for the earlier contest, for most of the off-road sections, the White Western Star will breeze through in high gear. The loading zone has become really boggy, and as we stopped, we'll need to drop back into auto for the moment. After picking up the trailer, we can cut through the church car park, straight across the road, through the front of the school, and then back on towards the old house. We completed that contest in 5 minutes 22, so that route leaves plenty of room for error. The final contest is meteorology data. We'll need to jump into the Chevy to do this one. I'll top up the Chevy using the fuel in the roof rack before we start. This is the path I like to take for this contest. It seems to offer a reasonable balance between time saved and risk. Using the Chevy with the least powerful engine and the balanced gearbox isn't going to set any records, but it should still be able to finish comfortably within the time limit. This one we managed to complete in 6 minutes 36, so again there's plenty of room for error. I'll leave the option open to give the Pinewood Express and Meteorology Data contests another go at a later stage, if it seems like we need the money. But for now, I'll leave it here for this episode. Thanks for watching.